Hey everyone, Holden here with Gold Plating Services. Today we're going to be talking about our Copper Strike solution. People often confuse Copper Strike as an activator because it's called a strike step, but really its main function is to be a visual verification for the activation step. This helps you save time and frustration. The use of Copper Strike usually occurs after step two, the activation step. You can think of Copper Strike as a 2.5 step. An optional step, but an important step in the electroplating process. We are going to discuss the attributes of Copper Strike, the benefits of adding Copper Strike to your plating process, and how to use Copper Strike. Copper Strike is a pretreatment solution that applies a very thin layer of copper onto the surface. This is known as a copper flash or strike. It is used in identifying any potential activation issues before proceeding with a final or hard plate, such as nickel or gold. Copper Strike is not recommended as a final plate, and if you're needing a thicker copper deposit, then please see our Bright Acid Copper solution. There are certain issues that can arise early in the plating process that can sometimes be difficult to catch or don't show up visually as defects until the final plate. These are often the result of a piece not properly wetting out, failed activation, overactivation, not rinsing a piece off properly between steps, or oxidization of the metal. This is what it looks like when an item is not wet out properly with ElectroClean. As you can see in this photo, you can see where places have dried out and the copper has not plated on to it properly. Failed activation is caused by using the wrong activator, using old activator that needs to be replaced, or not activating for long enough. Here's an example of an item that has not been activated for long enough, and you can see that the plate is not adhering to the surface of the metal. Here's an example of an item that has been overactivated. It might not look like much at first, but as you take a closer look, you can see darkening of the activation on the surface of the metal, which will still be visible in the final plate. And here's an example of an item that hasn't been rinsed off thoroughly. You can see the watermarks from where the item hasn't been rinsed off, causing it to look like this. And in this piece, you can see what oxidation looks like and how it shows up in the final plate. If a flaw is apparent once a final plate is applied, it is necessary to polish down the piece to the base metal and start over. If you have applied a hard metal such as nickel, palladium, or rhodium, removing the plate can be tedious, difficult, and time-consuming. Gold is easier to polish off, but it still takes some time. Removing precious metals from the surface is also not very cost-effective. This is a frustrating experience and can be avoided by using Copper Strike solution. When Copper Strike is added to the plating process, any potential defects will show up in the copper flash before you move on to applying any final plates. The copper flash is thin and the copper is easy to polish down, so when flaws occur, Copper Strike helps save time and money. It is also beneficial to use Copper Strike if you are starting a new project and are unsure how the plating process will go with particular parts or metals that you are plating. Using Copper Strike after proper activation and checking for adhesion before moving on can help you troubleshoot and refine your process. Copper Strike can be used in any setup, but may be particularly useful if you are working with metals that oxidize easily like steel, or that have a hard time remaining hydrophilic like brass. Including Copper Strike as an additional step can help provide a way to visually double check that a plating process is going smoothly before applying any final plates. One of the benefits of using it with non-stainless steel is that it can function as an activator, so you have step 2 and step 2.5 in your electroplating process covered. For some applications, the addition of copper may also increase conductivity. Copper Strike is the same solution for both brush and bath plating. It is used at room temperature for brush plating and is heated to 130 degrees Fahrenheit for bath plating. We recommend a stainless steel bit for brush plating and a copper anode for bath plating. You will also need air agitation for bath plating. Copper Strike is sensitive to changes in voltage and works well at 0.8 volts for bath plating. For brush plating, you will use a higher voltage, starting with 2 volts and going up to 4 volts. You will need to begin with the first step in the electroplating process, which is electrocleaning your item. You will want to make sure your item is wet out properly before moving on. Now that the item is wet out, we will move on to the activation. We recommend using Copper Strike for about 30 seconds, but if you're finding that 30 seconds is not long enough to get the copper to deposit onto the surface, then it's probably about time to replace your solution. After using Copper Strike, we will double check that our item has been activated and that there are no oxidization, watermarks, stains, or darkening. You can tell your solution is working by visually inspecting your item to ensure copper is visible on the surface. If you are starting a new project and are wanting to check a test piece for adhesion, you can dry your item after using the Copper Strike and do a tape test. Because the item is now dry, you'll need to electroclean it again before gold plating. After using Copper Strike and verifying that there are no defects, you'll be able to move on to the next step in the plating process. This is an example of a plating job that we did without following our own advice. We assumed the parts were a certain type of metal that they were not, and therefore we used the wrong activator. We also used Copper Strike, but did not do a tape test to check for adhesion before applying a thick gold plate. You can see in the photo that the gold began buckling and flaking. If we had done a single test piece initially and also checked for adhesion after the Copper Strike, we would have learned much earlier in the process that our activation had failed and saved ourselves a lot of time. Hey everyone, I hope this video has helped you have a better understanding on our Copper Strike solution and how to use it effectively in the electroplating process. If you do have any questions about our Copper Strike solution, you can reach us by either our phone or our tech email. Thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.